Good morning, class 6. This is your English class. In the previous video, we have already started chapter 4.2 of unit 4, that is about the topic the Panchatantra. In the previous video, we have already started the first part of this chapter, and in this video, we are going to study the next part of this chapter. So, students, now open page number 99 in your English book and let's start read. The introductory part of the Panchatantra goes like this. The introductory part of the Panchatantra goes like this. Many ages ago, there lived a wise king who ruled his kingdom ideally. What ideally means? Ideally means perfectly, in a most suitable manner. So, ideally means perfectly or in a most suitable manner. So, many years back, there lived an intelligent king who ruled his kingdom perfectly or who ruled his kingdom in a most suitable manner. Okay. Many years back, there lived an intelligent king who ruled his kingdom perfectly or who ruled his kingdom in a most suitable manner. He had 3 sons, but none of them had any intelligence. The king had 3 sons, but they were not intelligent. Okay? The king had 3 sons, but they were not intelligent. Any one of his sons were not intelligent. Okay? The king had 3 sons, but none of them had any intelligence. The king was worried about who he would make his heir to the throne. Okay? What heir means? Heir means the person who will have the legal right to be the next king or queen. Okay? The person who will have the legal right to become the next king or queen is called heir. Okay? So, see, the king was worried means the king became worried about the fact that to whom he will make the king to his kingdom, as his sons had no intelligence. That's why the king became worried about the fact that to whom he will make the next king to his kingdom. So, once again I am telling, the king became worried about the fact that as his sons were not intelligent, so to whom he would make the proper inheritor or he would make the proper king to his kingdom. He was eager to find a good and knowledgeable teacher for his sons. Someone who could make them learn in scriptures. What knowledgeable and scriptures means? See here. Knowledgeable. Knowledgeable means knowing a lot. Scriptures means holy books. Okay, you know. Knowledgeable means knowing a lot. He was eager to find a good and knowledgeable teacher for his sons. Means the king was become very excited to find out a very good and very knowledgeable teacher for his sons who could make his sons to learn the holy books. Okay, so the king became very excited about this fact that he tried to find out a very good and very knowledgeable teacher for his sons who could make his sons to learn about the holy books. The king's minister told him of a scholarly pandit, okay, named Vishnu Sharma, who was known for his wisdom, okay. When the king became very excited to find out a very good and knowledgeable teacher for his sons to teach them the holy books, then the minister of the king told him about a scholarly pandit whose name was Vishnu Sharma, and he was known for his intelligence. Okay? See, scholarly. Scholarly means having a lot of knowledge. Okay? Scholarly means having a lot of knowledge. So, when the king became very excited to find out a very good and very intelligent, very knowledgeable teacher for his sons to teach them the holy books, the minister of the king informed him that there was a very knowledgeable pandit whose name was Vishnu Sharma, and he is specially known for his intelligence. But this pandit was quite old, but this pandit was completely old. The king wondered if the pandit would live long enough to train his sons in scriptures. Hearing that from his minister, the king wondered if the pandit would live enough to train his sons to make them able to learn the holy books. Even an intelligent person would take more than 12 years to master the scriptures, while the king's sons were just nincompoops. Nincompoops means, see? Nincompoops means stupid persons. Okay? So, the king wondered about the fact that if the pandit will live long, then he can teach his sons properly. Even an intelligent person take more than 12 years to learn the holy books properly. Okay, while the king's sons were just stupid, then they will take more than 12 years to learn the holy books. Okay. However, Pandit Vishnu Sharma convinced the king that he would teach the princess through a series of interesting stories, which would be more effective than the scriptures. Then, Pandit Vishnu Sharma convinced the king that he would teach the princess through a series of interesting stories, which would be more effective than the scriptures. Okay. Okay. Then Pandit Vishnu Sharma told the king that he will teach his sons through a series of interesting stories, which will be more effective than the main scripture of the holy book. Okay. The king agreed to this, and the king agreed to this. During the process of his teaching, Vishnu Sharma compiled a collection of stories which he termed Panchatantra. Okay? During the process of his teaching, the Pandit Vishnu Sharma compiled, what compiled means put together in the form of a book. Put together in a form of a book. Okay. Vishnu Sharma compiled a collection of stories which he termed Panchatantra. Okay. Once again I am telling this stanza. Pandit Vishnu Sharma convinced the king that he will tell some stories टू हिज सन्स. दोज विल बी मोर इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरीज एंड मोर इफेक्टिव देन द मेन स्क्रिप्चर. ओके. द किंग एग्रीड टू दिस फैक्ट. द किंग एग्रीड विथ हिम. आफ्टर दैट इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ टीचिंग विष्णु शर्मा टेक टूगेदर सम कलेक्शन ऑफ स्टोरीज दैट इज टर्म्ड एज पंचतंत्र. ओके. सो नेक्स्ट गिवेन व्हाट आर द थीम ऑफ पंचतंत्र एंड वी विल स्टडी इट इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो.